defense forces defend the state of Israel and the Jewish people. Service is compulsory for all Israelis between the ages of 18 and 21. Still, thousands of young Jews from around the world voluntarily enlist in the IDF every year as lone soldiers, whom the IDF depends upon for their renowned dedication and inspiration. And these lone soldiers depend on us.
Hi, my name is Bernardo. I'm from Mexico. I was a lone soldier.
My name is Yoni Steinberg. I made Aliyah from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania about a month ago.
Hi, my name is Craig. I made Aliyah from South Africa about 6 years ago.
My name is Ayano Fanton. I came from Ethiopia.
I'm Katie. I'm from Los Angeles, and I was a combat soldier in OCITS, the elite canine unit of the IDF.
My name is Daniel Fleisch. I'm from New Jersey. I was born here in Israel, left when I was young, and then came back to be a lone soldier, serving the IDF, and live here.
The years a soldier spends in the army are some of the most physically and emotionally trying years he or she will ever face. It is thanks to their families and communities that they are ready to take on the challenges that await them. Beyond the physical demands, soldiers face long periods of time away from their loved ones, nights without sleep, uncomfortable and dirty uniforms, emotional exhaustion, and the loss of their independence. But for lone soldiers, the Army's perennial challenges can be uniquely disruptive.
So what ends up happening is we keep calling each other, are you here yet, are you here yet? Whoever gets here first makes a mad dash to the supermarket, buys whatever food they can, and if we're lucky, we get a warm Shabbat meal. But that doesn't always happen.
So one time I came back to my apartment after a long 2 weeks in the Army, really tired of having an operation, I had no time to take care of my bills. I came back to my apartment, opened the door, no electricity. And before Shabbat, there's really no time to start calling the landlord and getting electricity paid, getting my bills paid.
I found myself doing laundry in the bathtub, but looking at 6 or 8 at night for some laundromat that was still open right before I go back to the Army, and then you gotta find a way to dry it. Having laundry lines all over the apartment, hoping things will dry in the winter, putting little having all types of contraptions, these little heaters, trying to dry your clothes before you go back to base. In the Army, everyone's equal inside the Army. The second you leave the base, that's when your difficulties start as well.
Sometimes I lay under the moon. I thank God I'm breathing. And I pray, don't take me soon, 'cause I am here for a reason. Sometimes in my tears I drown, but I never let it get me down. So when negativity surrounds, I know someday it'll all turn around. Because all my life I've been waiting for, I've been praying for the people to say that we don't wanna fight no more. There'll be no more war, and our children will pay one day.
In 2009, a group of recently released lone soldiers banded together to provide support for those still serving. Together, they founded the Michael Levine Memorial Center for Lone Soldiers.
Once I was injured and I was in the hospital, and having no family to come visit me, he came and picked me up and helped me with everything, even though I couldn't move. For this and much, I'm very grateful to him. To the Merkaz HaHayalim HaBodedim.
It was when I first got out of the Army. I didn't really have any direction. I didn't have any contacts in Israel. I don't really have any family here, a couple of distant cousins. But I was really lost. I didn't know what to do. I looked for work for a couple of months, unsuccessfully. And it wasn't until I called the Lone Soldier Center, where I was connected with a Chayal Boded who actually got out of the Army a year before me, where I was given a connection to a job. He connected me with a high-tech company in Tel Aviv, where I ended up working for a year. And that was a situation where, honestly, I don't know what I would have done if it wasn't for the Lone Soldier Center. You know, when you get out of the Army, you're completely, as a Chayal Boded, as a lone soldier, you're completely lost. No real direction, no connections. And having the center really, really helps you keep that feeling of community, the feeling of family, and connectedness.
When we were released from the army, we moved to an apartment in Tel Aviv, and the Lone Soldier Center arranged furniture that we wouldn't have been able to afford otherwise.
Not only that, but when we actually moved apartments in Tel Aviv, the Lone Soldier Center came and helped us move. To move, to even rent a truck for the day in Tel Aviv, costs over 1,500 shekels. And honestly, it's another situation where I just don't know what I would have done without it. So, no, I want to say thank you. Thanks
thank
for all your
you.
Help.
In its first 10 months alone, the Lone Soldier Center has already come to the aid of more than 1,000 lone soldiers. The Michael Levine Memorial Center has already made its mark on the lives of many lone soldiers, but the center is seeking support to reach the thousands still in need. The Jewish people rely on the lone soldiers, and the lone soldiers, in turn, rely on us.